You know, it's interesting, Meek, because his first name is seemingly missing an E, but his gas tank is always full. We got Alexander Romanov in this one, 15-0, taking on Chase Sherman, 15-9, who, pretty interesting, they decided not to renew the Vanilla Gorilla's contract. 4 days later, however, Tanner Boser, who was Romanov's original opponent, is forced to pull out, and the UFC just like, call up the Vanilla Gorilla, because you know he will be down. And one thing I found very fascinating was this fight was originally kind of buried on the prelims. Tanner Boser was a decent dog, about plus 400. Romanov, a sizable favorite, minus 500. But ever since getting the replacement of the Vanilla Gorilla, it's now third from the top. Romanov, still undefeated, is like a minus 1200 favorite. So obviously everyone, Vegas and the UFC included, are kind of anticipating this to be easy work for Romanov, and makes sense. I mean, the guy is 15-0. He's been looking nothing but impressive in the UFC. I mean, he's got a win over my boy Juan Espino, and that fight was admittedly very controversial. I thought that Juan Espino should have got the decision in that one, but there was some strange circumstances that contributed to that split technical decision for Romanov. But he did look good in that fight. I mean, he had a lot of dominant moments. He clearly won a round, and then obviously a lot of people thought he won two. So that was impressive for me. And then most recently he took out the Mountain, Jared Vandera, who has fallen on some tough times recently, but Romanov was kind of one of the first guys to do that to Vandera. And Chase Sherman, again, kind of singing a different tune. I mean, he lost three straight, got smoked by Arlovsky, got smoked by Parker Porter, and got smoked by Jake Collier in a fight that was non-competitive, over in 2.5 minutes. And Collier, you know, not really known as a big finisher. So I think the UFC was like, man, if you're going to go out there and get smoked in 2.5 minutes by Jake Collier, then there just isn't much for you here. Unless it's a short notice circumstance fight like this. So what are your thoughts on this one? I know you're picking Romanov, but how early is it going to be?
Yeah, I mean, King Kong is going to get it done. Vanilla Gorilla has zero chance because King Kong is the true and one and only King Gorilla. This is an absolute layup. There's a reason why King Kong is a minus 1400. But with that being said, I would stay far away from this. Maybe hit some props or something. But, I mean, this is a lock nonetheless, in my opinion. But those odds just... there's just really nothing appetizing about this meet. But very excited to see this fight. Very excited to see Chase Sherman get sent to PFL. Maybe we'll have some good luck there. But yeah, this is an absolute wrap for King Kong.
Yeah, definitely a wrap. 98%. I mean, you see the discrepancy. 98% is rolling with Romanov in this one. About 40% of it is Brown for that KO. A majority of it is rolling with that copper sub, though. Do you think that it's going to be a KO or a sub? And are you predicting first round similar to what the homie Jake Collier did to Sherman?
Yeah, first round. And yeah, it's got to be a finish. It's going to be either sub or KO. I hope it's KO, but it would not surprise me if it gets a sub.
With you all the way, I'm rolling with Romanov. I think the submission is pretty safe. If you can find a KO slash TKO slash submission prop, I think that that is worth it. But if you're going one way or the other, picking the KO, TKO, or the submission, then there's definitely some risk on both sides. Kind of reminds me of the Tom Aspinall versus Volkov fight the other week, where you're getting great odds for that submission, great odds for that KO, but if you call the wrong side, then you could be having some burnt meat. So with you, going to roll with Romanov, going to go by finish. I think there's no chance that the Vanilla Gorilla makes this a three-round fight. And similarly, I think there's no chance that he makes this a winning fight. So both of us going with Romanov. Let us know in the comments if you are taking the Vanilla Gorilla or if you're taking the actual gorilla in the King Kong. Let us know.